Hey guys, welcome back to the next video. If you're new to the channel, welcome. This is Richard from WELSHYTECH, and today we have the Ocypus Sigma L360 Pro in white. Should you consider it? Let's find out, shall we? Okay then, so we do have something else from Ocypus. This time it's the Sigma L360 Pro in white. Has a screen. So, let's get this unboxed now and then we'll go through some of the specs. So, yeah, it's not the conventional way of you actually unboxing, but, oh well. Now, I haven't looked at this yet, so this is going to be first for both of us. Let me get these boxes out the way and I'll be back. Okay, then, so we'll have a look at some of the accessories now. Okay, so, okay. Right, it comes with a lot of accessories. Comes with a fan connector or fan splitter. Comes with the back plates for AMD as well as Intel. Comes with all the screws and mounting, the springs. Does it come with thermal paste? Yes, but there as well. Cool, that's cool. Ooh, then it comes obviously with a manual. So that's cool. Let's get this out the way. Okay, this is the screen. But sure, this is what I'm thinking. Yeah, but there, screen components. So this is the little screen that attaches. Yes, yeah, done by magnets. And, ooh, okay, I like the look of it. It looks quite spacey. I don't like that. But at least it's all standard ARGB as well as PWM, so it's not so bad. But I wish they had done that a bit more cleanly. But it doesn't matter. So, let's get this out now and I'll show you the rest. Okay, so this is the AIO now. Look at the size on that. That is redundant. Look at that. That's ridiculous. So, let's just attach the screen. I want to see what it looks like first. So, I've seen pictures. It looks like it's going to look really nice. So, let's have a look. So, it's going to go on. These annoying cables are away now. So, it's going to go like this. Is it like that? Oh, right. Okay. So, that's not bad, actually. The screen there. That's not actually bad. Yeah, it looks quite cool. That's what it looks like, the screen. That looks nice. It does. Well, yeah, once it's on there, the magnets aren't... Yeah, that ain't coming off once it's there. So, you can orientate this anyway with the tubes facing upward, downwards. I personally would probably do it this way, but that's just me. Especially in a build, that would look quite nice, but yeah. And then, of course, then we got the fans, which these fans look very nice. I like the outer bearings. They seem very, very nice. The connections were there. That was on the other AIO I did and reviewed, and I like this. This is quite cool. It makes everything look just perfect. That is lovely. It's embroidered on the side of the radiator on both sides. That's cool. Right, so let's get to some of the specs. Now, what I'm going to do first of all, do the CPU sockets. So, as with CPU sockets, this does support LGA 1150 series. That'll be 1150, 1155, 1156, and so forth. 1200, 1700, 1851, and then AM4 and AM5. Now, as for the tube, that's 400 millimeters by 12.5 in diameter. The fan quantity is 3. Now, the whole weight of this is 1,680 grams. The dimensions for the pump or the and the radiator, of course. The radiator is 397 by 120 by 27. That's a standard radiator. The fans, not that, sorry, the pump by here is 80 by 78 by 97 millimeters. Now, the pump speed is 3000 RPM with a noise decibel rating of 30 dB. It's a 3-pin. Please get rid of the 3-pin, but 4-pin. It's 12 volt DC with a rate current at 0.4 amps with a 4.8 watt consumption. Wow. The fans are 120 by 120 by 25, a basic fan. Fluid dynamic bearings. The speeds ranges are between 520 400 RPM, and then it's 500 and 2000 RPM with the speed control cable. The airflow is 90 CFM, 57 CFM with the speed control cable. The air pressure is 5.8 millimeter H2O or 4.65 millimeter H2O with a speed cable. The decibel rating is between 36 and 29. That is with the cable that's included. The voltage is 12 volt DC. The amperage or the current is 0 to 6 amp with a 3.12 watt with a 4-pin connector. That's the fans. Now, as for the display, the screen is 3.5 inches. It's an IPS display. The resolution is 640 by 480. It's ARGB. It's 3-pin. Does come, obviously, with the USB cable that you need to plug into a USB port in the bottom. It's 5 volt DC with a 0.6 amp with a 3 wattage. I like the look. It looks quite cool. So let's get this on test bench now and see how it performs. Get these standoffs here. Now, you do plug these. You do screw these into the standoffs on the... This is for AMD specifically, AM5. AM4 would be the same process, except you probably have to hold the back plate. So just put them in. Now, these, obviously, these will tighten down when you screw the actual block on. So what we'll do now is just make sure all you want to do is finger tight. That's it for the bracket. Okay, now this is the AM4. Or M5 bracket, so it'll go in like this, slides on just like that, and that's done. Put some thermal paste on. Of course, that thermal paste application is going to vary, depends on what you've actually read or watched online, but usually it's just a line in the middle. Now, what I'm going to do is grab the block itself. Now, it will have the Ocypus lettering there. That's primarily where you want to actually have it lined up. Make sure, of course, you pull out the cable as well. I suggest pulling the cable like this around. It looks a bit neater. So this is how you place it down. You place it down like this. Now, squeeze it like that. Now, that will just spread out the thermal paste and it'll stay in position. Then you get these. These are the mounting screws. So they are... They have got screw like little springs in them, so these will originally bottom out. What you want to do is a crisscross pattern, so start one side. Best thing to do is just get the thread going. So just start with the threads like that. Right, okay, so now you want to get a screwdriver. And what you want to do is screw each side, they're obviously in a crisscross pattern. So if I was you, start from one point like that, start from that one down like that, like that. This will give perfect tension across for the CPU. This is mainly for even spread for the thermal paste. So just keep going until they fully bottom out. They will bottom out, so don't go trying to over tighten because you can damage something. Then what you're going to do is finish that up, so like that, just like that, just like that, and just like that. Now that is it for the actual installation part of the block itself. Now let's get onto the screen and then the wiring first. Okay, so that header you see there, that would be for the pump. So all you want to do is take the pump header, that is a 3-pin, unfortunately. So you want to just put it there now and just place it correctly on the pump header. This was, obviously, you will have to do the cable management yourself, but once that's done, then it's done. Then this is the screen. Now this screen does come with ARGB connections as well as the USB port connection for the USB at the bottom of the motherboard. First of all, what I'm going to do is how you mount it. So first of all, is what you want to do is it only goes one way. Well, actually, you can mount it different directions, but go like that, and it will just snap into place. Now, get to the cables. Now that 3-pin connection right there, that is the ARGB connector. Now what you want to do is take the end of this, which is a 3-pin ARGB, you want to connect it to the header just like this. Take the both ends, go like this, plug it in, and then that is done for the ARGB. So That port right there is a USB 2 header. This will be directly on the bottom of your motherboard. So what you want to do is this connector that comes with the screen, which will have USB on it. What you want to do is put it down into that header down here, just like that. And then that is how you connect up the screen, which, if you can see, it has power now. And that's it for the installation. Okay, so this is the Oki display. Now, this is the overall screen and the overall software. Now, it does come with 9 different presets, which obviously you can see I'm already on one. What I will say is the response time is very, very fast. The display looks very, very nice as well. It is a TFT panel, so it's not bad. It looks nice. The brightness is very nice. The overall color saturation is very nice. But in terms of the software, you can adjust the brightness from up to down. You can add your own modes. You can add text, data. This will be loaded like CPU temperatures. You can add different types of stuff to it. But if you want to quit that, you just go to this live. This will be under live. You can rotate it, which is quite cool. But other than that, I mean, it's not bad. Now, for this type of thing, that these would be the videos. Now, these are just different settings or different resolutions. You can have it in a horizontal or a vertical, which is quite cool. But other than that, really, the software for that is basically that. You can do computer configuration. It'll tell you what your system specs are. And then you come to system specification to tell you what exactly you've got. But other than that, that's really much it, except for, like, checking for updates. That's pretty much it for when it comes to the software. The software is very basic, but there's no stutters. The response is very, very fast when it comes to that. You can add, you can delete these themes, and then you can add your own. So, considering, it's not actually bad, and the software is quite easy to use. This is the Ocypus Sigma Pro. This is the fans of 50%. Very quiet at 50%. Now, 100%. Very, very loud at 100%. Okay, so when it comes to the overall test system, some things have changed. This time it is a Ryzen 9 7900. It does have 32 gigs of DDR5 from A-Pacer. It is a Sapphire B850 WiFi Nitro Plus motherboard. It's got 2 terabytes of NVMe storage and another 2 terabyte for NVMe storage backup. It's also got an RX 7800 XT Nitro. It's also got a 1000 watt cooling power supply, and it's housed in the BQH Shadowbase 800 FX. Now, as for the testing, my same run of benchmark CPU for Cinebench, Blender Pavilion, Blender Classroom, and 3D Mark Super Test. Now, just so you know, these tests are done for 20 minutes. They run for 20 minutes, and I leave the CPU cooler idolized or just equalized during the test, because it'll start off high, and then once the liquid inside starts to equalize, the temps will start to bottom out during the test. So for 50% fan speed, the CPU power draw was 180 watts at high with a low at 172. CPU clocks high at 5.4 with a low at 5.1. Now, for Cinebench R23, the idles were 31 with a max of 81. The Blender Pavilion idles 31 with a max of 80. Blender Classroom idles 31 with a max of 79 Celsius, and 3D Mark Test the idles with 31 with a max of 71 Celsius. Now, for 100% fan speed, the CPU power draw was high at 182 watts with a low at 177. The CPU clocks are exactly the same, high at 5.4 and low at 5.1. Now, Cinebench R23, the idles were 1 degree higher, but that could be a margin of error. So the 32 degrees are idle through all the tests, but the max was 80. Blender Pavilion, the idles are 32 with a max of 77. Blender Classroom idles 32 with a max of 76. And 3D Mark Super Test idles 32 with a max of 64 Celsius. Now, I'm going to put up a graph showing you how this performs against other coolers through Cinebench, Blender, as well as 3D Mark Super Test. Remember, each test will hit the CPU differently. Now, Cinebench, of course, is very high, very hard instruction set, and any CPU it's meant to push it as hard as possible, where Blender will utilize more clock speed as well as multi-threading. But then when it comes to 3D Mark is a bit different. It will utilize multi-core as well as single core boost. So just remember that the high temperatures or the low temperatures with 3D Mark are always going to be different. It depends on how good the cooler is as well as the pump. So this is where the graphs will show. Okay then, so what did you think of that? Yeah, a lot to go through. Now, when it comes to AIOs with screens, as you already know, I've actually done quite a few of these through the channel, mainly from Thermalright. Now, I've done a lot of Thermalright coolers. I've done a couple more from other brands, but this one's got a bit of a unique look to it. It's got more of a floating design when it comes to the overall actual pump housing. Now, something I'm going to tell you is that the fans on this are very, very loud at 100%. Now, that is with the side panel on during testing and me from a distance away from the case, and they are very, very loud at 100%. But of course, you can always adjust that to 60, maybe 75, and the noise won't be as much. Now, this is $136.99 at this current moment on Amazon.com, and I mean, it's there when it comes to pricing. I mean, it's up there with some of Thermalright coolers. Now, yes, this is a very nice looking AIO. The screen, I do like the screen, especially the overall design. It looks really, really nice. The insulation, easy, very simple. It's not overcomplicated and it's easy. Now, when it comes to like some of the feedback I'm gonna give now, I don't like the three pin pump connector. It should be 4 pin, I'm sorry, but in 2025 the connector should be a standard at four pin. It gives you the overall controllability, so you can control it properly. Now, as you probably did see through like some of the b-roll and stuff, the cables, yeah, there's quite a few, but that's just one of them things. This is white, and obviously I've got a black case, so it's gonna stand out more. But what I'm gonna say is a big thank you to Ocypus for sending this out. I really like it, and as for thermals, it's one of the best that I've tested so far on the channel. And quite honestly, it's the 360. It'll pretty much handle any CPU out there, except for Intel 13th or 14th gen, of course. But other than that, very good AIO, and if you want to buy one, I will leave a link down below, and a big thank you to Ocypus. And make sure you subscribe to the channel, because I've got stuff here from Thermaltake, I've got stuff coming from Sapphire, I've got stuff from Antec, I've got stuff here from Gamdias, I've got loads of stuff here, Hatter, I've got stuff here from Kingston, I've got absolute tons of stuff coming, so make sure you subscribe to the channel. And as always, this is Richard from WELSHYTECH. I hope you guys have a fantastic week and weekend ahead of you. Goodbye.